Hello. Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to today's webinar session hosted by Magna Infotech Care Services. Magna Infotech Care Services is a learning platform aimed at bridging the gap between one expertise and growing industry expectations. The prime objective is to provide IT skills training to individuals, aligning them to the skill sets that are most sought by organizations today, while also preparing them for future industry trends. This webinar provides a brief overview of data science. Data science is a study of where information comes from, what it represents, and how it can be turned into a valuable resource in the creation of business and IT strategies. The number of new data science and analytics jobs advertised per month increased by 78% between April 2017 to April 2018. Job roles such as business analyst, data engineer, analytics engineer are in high demand across leading companies. I take the pleasure of introducing the speaker for today's session, Mr. Abhaya. He is an expert in the field of Python. He has 20 years in training, education sector, and IT. Field of experience, data science with Python, machine learning. Now, hand over the session to Mr. Abhaya. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Aishwarya. Hello, everyone, and welcome aboard. Today, I'm going to talk about like the reason why we are over here. And it's a short session, although I have a lot of things to cover. But in 1 hour time, I'll try my level best to explain what exactly data science is and why it is so popular these days, why everybody is running for data science, why it is hot in the industry, what are the major trends going on in the industry today. So we'll talk in detail about all these things. Just to start with, let me give you my brief introduction. My name is Abhay Agarwal and I've been into IT industry for almost 20 years. I started my career in 2001 after doing BCA, MCA and MBA from Narsee Monji, Mumbai. I started from Tata Teleservices as a systems analyst, then I joined American Express as a business analyst. I worked in various organizations. I worked in GE Capital for 2 years, IBM for 4 years, HSBC, HDPI unit in Bangalore for another 3 years. And my final job was in United Health Group. I worked there as a data scientist and left it in 2009. And since then, I've been into training and development. I have delivered more than 1,500 plus trainings in Unix shell scripting, Python scripting, as well as Python machine learning with deep learning, artificial intelligence, natural language processing, as well as in PMP side. I'm certified PMP professional, I'm certified SAS professional, I'm certified Unix professional. So be assured for 1 hour, whatever the knowledge I'm going to give you is going to help you in long run. So let's start off for the day, and the agenda is the power of data science, why we are over here, just to understand what is data science and what is the benefit of working on data science. So we already have a discussion about myself. So why do we need data science? The agenda for today is why do we need data science? What is data science as a whole picture? Evolution of data science since the beginning around, so this is a quite old topic. Artificial intelligence came into existence in the 1960s from perceptual algorithms. Since then it has been evolved to a next level. And today we are at the stage where we are still in growing phase. We cannot say we are in mature state. Demand for data science in the market, why it is so high, what is people are expecting from us. Roadmap for becoming a data scientist, so what are the steps you have to take down the line, maybe for 6 months or maybe for 1 year to become a data scientist. Responsibilities of a data scientist in a company, MICS data science certificate, and when to start, what are the benefits of enrolling for Magna Infotech, what are the projects we are going to discuss at Magna Infotech, and question and answer session. So I'll be covering all these things in a 1 hour session without any break. So why do we need data science? The question comes in mind. What is data? First of all, what is data science and why do we need it? So if you talk about a historical data, like if you talk about 10 years back or not 10 years, maybe 8 years back, you can see the data we were having in a structured format. We were having a lot of warehouses like a SAS data set. SAS is a very popular tool around 10 years back. We're working on data warehousing tool. Similarly, Abnition, Hyperion, SBase, Abnition, Abnitio, and Hyperion SBase were very popular tools for data warehousing. Traditional BI tools were there. Similarly, predefined reports are there. So everything was there in place. then the need come for data science is because of the scalability of the data that has been increased. You might have observed, like, Amazon is having almost like 10 lakh transactions per day. Similarly, Twitter, Twitch, Facebook, all the social social networking websites, they are getting the terabytes of data on a daily basis. And it is beyond the capabilities of a single machine to process that huge amount of data. So what do we need to do? We need some scalable systems like Hadoop or Spark systems, which is going to divide the data into smaller parts, sending it to different machines. There they are going to process it and sending back the results to the server. And that is known as a MapReduce framework. So MapReduce framework is something which is there in Hadoop and Spark, which is capable of working on terabytes of data. Nowadays, you can see a lot of unstructured data is also there. So unstructured means like a voice, like a song, like a video, like a audio, like a Twitter tweet, like a WhatsApp message, or maybe in a form of a string. So we have a lot of structured and unstructured data. We have a lot of algorithms there also in hand for data analytics, like linear regression is for finding the relationship in a form of a straight line, then logistic regression is there, then random forest is there, then naive-based classifier is there, then support vector machine is there. So there's so many algorithms in statistics which is helpful for analyzing this data in a beautiful manner, or finding the relation between the independent and the dependent variables. So we have our algorithms in place, and Python is one of the languages which has all these algorithms already inbuilt over there. There's a library in Python called sklearn, which is having all these algorithms already placed over there. So you just need to call that library and call that function for linear regression and fit in the data into it, and it is going to find what is slope and what is intercept. So all these algorithms have been there in the industry for a long time, but it becomes popular now because of one reason, that is Python. Python is having this all libraries inbuilt over there. And that is the reason we are working on data science these days using Python. Then we have our scientific discoveries, scientific discovery related algorithms pertaining to deep learning, pertaining to artificial intelligence. And that is the reason we are working on, I'm sorry, the screen is paused, I believe. Oh, can you see it now, everyone? Okay, everyone can hear my voice, right? Okay, so we have not missed any of the things. I've just moved to single slide. I just talked about the agenda for today. So what is the need of data science, and I'm on this slide. Okay, I'm really sorry, I just didn't realize my screen is paused. So we are all set now, right? Ashwarya, everything is fine, right? We can go ahead, right? Okay, great. I don't realize it. So we have not skipped any of the material. We are just on the first slide. Okay, great. Okay, so if I talk about the historical data, we were having all the data in a form of a structured format, in a form of a data warehouse, in a BI or a predefined report. But nowadays, the data has been converted to a different format altogether, and different sources are giving different kind of a data. Like if you talk about a Facebook, every minute we are getting a data in a form of a music or a video or a audio, or maybe some kind of a strings, or maybe some kind of a smileys or images. So data is coming from the different sources in different formats, and in order to process it, we need some robust tool to work on it. And Python is that robust tool which is working on the same, because Python has got 65,000 libraries. In Python, we have 65,000 libraries which are helpful for understanding or analyzing this data in a better manner. Now, coming to the next slide. What is data science? The question comes is, what is data science? If you talk about the dictionary definition of a data science, it is a study of where information comes from. It represents what it represents and how it is turned into a valuable resource. So there are three parts of it if you see closely. A study of where information comes from. So information can come from different sources, from the internet, maybe from the website, maybe from the internal sources, maybe from the table, maybe from the external repositories. So data can come from any source. What it represents means what this data is all about, what is this data is talking all about, and how to turn into valuable information. My screen is shared, right, Ashwarya? But the slides are not visible. I started sharing it. Yeah, I started sharing it some time back. Okay. So if you talk about the definition of a data science, it is study of information, study of from where this information comes from, how it represents, and it is talking about the valuable information that we can fetch. I'll take a simple example. One of the popular website is Trivago. Trivago website is made in Python only. There's a tool in Python called Django framework, which is helpful for creating end-to-end presentation, end-to-end web applications. And in this, what we do, we fetch the data from the different airlines website or maybe different hotel websites, and giving the information in a single page. For what it is doing web scraping. So this topic is known as web scraping, which is very much easy to implement in Python using libraries like Beautiful Soup, like Scrappy, like Request. There are many libraries in Python which are helpful for web scraping. So what it is doing, it is fetching the information from the different websites and showing it on the single page. And that, so in this definition, how it fits from where the information comes, it is coming from the different websites. What it represents, it represents the prices of the hotels, and it is giving some valuable information in the front end, in the single page, what are the prices of the hotel, and you can select one of them and go to book the hotel from there. So data science is all about processing the raw data, transforming into a desired format, cleansing it. Cleansing it means, suppose there's a field which is having a numerical value, you have to convert to a number by removing dollar symbols from there. So you clean it. There are some missing values, you want to deal with them. Some values are garbage values, you want to remove them. You want to merge the fields, you want to cleanse it, you want to join it, you want to concatenate it. So all these things can be done very easily using pandas library in Python. So in Python, we have a library called pandas, which is helpful on doing this. Once we do all this data exploration step, so this is all known as data exploration, we prepare a model. Model is nothing but a statistical algorithm, which is already implemented in Python. We call it. We use that function of logistic regression maybe and fit in the data into it and find the relationship between the independent variables, and finally making the decision out of it or making some predictions out of it. So this is all about data science, in which we gather the data, we process it, and finally taking decisions out of it. Now, concept behind data science is nothing new, just a terminology is new. So we have been doing this data science for a long time, but now it is changing because of the implementation of SQLon library in the Python or Seaborn library in Python for graphical analytics. So if I talk about the important libraries in Python, so just to write it down. So we have important libraries in Python, that is pandas. Pandas is for data analytics. We have NumPy. NumPy is for numerical analysis. We have Matplotlib for plotting some graphs. We have Seaborn, again for plotting graphs. We have SQLon for machine learning. And we have other libraries like Beautiful Soup for web scraping. And there are other libraries for deep learning, like that is Keras and TensorFlow for deep learning. Now, what is deep learning and how it is different from machine learning? So machine learning is all about predictive analysis. So when I say I want to predict something based on the historical data, it is known as machine learning. And let's say I give you the historical data of humidity, rainfall, temperature, and crop yield. Suppose I say humidity, temperature, and crop, and let's say rainfall, and crop yield. Suppose I give you this historical data of last 10 years of humidity, rainfall, and temperature, and crop yield as a dependent variable, and ask you to predict it for 2019 December. What you'll do? You'll implement some machine learning algorithm to find the linear relationship between them. Once you find the linear relationship, you are going to predict it for future. Now, in this prediction, these variables are very much important: humidity, temperature, and rainfall. Suppose I incorporate one more column here called farmer age. So farmer age is not a very significant column which is impacting the crop yield. So what we'll do, we are going to remove it because it's not a very impactful column which is impacting the crop yield. Well, we are going to remove it. So data scientist has to do what? He has to remove the fields which are not important or which are redundant, and it's a very tedious job. So imagine a telecom data having almost 100 fields. It's really impossible for a data scientist to analyze all the fields and remove it or keep it. So the better way is deep learning. Deep learning do this feature extraction on its own. So what is the benefit of deep learning? Deep learning benefit is that feature extraction is automatic. And these deep learning algorithms are not shared by Google. So this concept is given by Google, and they have not shared these deep learning algorithms. They just told the name of these algorithms and the basic concepts behind it, but still it's a black box. So in every machine learning or data science kind of a project, we have a raw data, we have a data structure, data repository, where we store our data, maybe a table, maybe a MongoDB, or maybe any Sybase. We relate the data in the form of a data warehouse. We put a hierarchical structure if you want. And then we use traditional BI tools to analyze it, and we create some reports out of it. So this we have been doing for a long time, almost 15, 20 years people are doing this. Now, role of data analyst is to analyze the data and give the final results to the business decision makers. So maximum time is going on decision making. So almost like it's strongly written over here, it's 50% time is just analyzing the data. Then modeling and iteration takes 10%, strategizing is another 10 to 15%, and then analytics is last 10%. So data preparation and cleansing takes maximum time, that is 65%. Decision making is just a 5%. So data preparation and cleansing means once you get the data from external sources, you make it more scalable or more structured. Removing the null values, cleansing out the data, removing the dollar symbols from the fields, removing the commas from the fields, converting the string type data into numbers if they are into numbers, converting the numbers into strings if they are formatted as a string. So all these things are done in data preparation and cleansing, also known as data wrangling step. So this step is known as the data wrangling. So 65% of the time goes into data cleansing. Then 5% in decision making, then 10% in iteration modeling, strategizing, and analytics. Now, if you talk about revolution of a data, the new era of data has come, like because of social media websites, wherein we have so many terabytes of data coming on the daily basis or every minute basis. And in order to scale up this kind of a requirement, we use Hadoop and Spark environments. So in the previous time, we were not having this much huge amount of data. Now it is there. That's the reason we have a petabytes of unstructured data. And the traditional BI tools like Hyperion, Sbase, Amnistio, these are not able to analyze it because of the different sources and different formats. So traditional BI tools fails over there. Now if we talk about a business intelligence and data science, so BI tools, what they can do and what data science can do, there's a huge difference. So business intelligence is something which is looking backward. Looking backward means it is analyzing the historical data and giving the results to you. Data science is something which is looking forward. Forward means it is predicting something for you in the future. Suppose you give the historical data and you want to predict the sales of a car based on the last 20 years of sales, you can predict it. BI cannot predict it. BI can just analyze it. In business intelligence, data can be structured, semi-structured, or mostly numerical data we are dealing with. But in data science, we can deal with all kind of data, whether it's a structured, non-structured, whether it's a discrete or a continuous, all data can be handled very easily. In BI, we generally create reports, predict and prescribe and optimize. But in data science, we explore, we discover, we investigate and visualize in a proper manner. BI is a big investment, delivers exact reports, but data science is a limited investment, might or might not deliver correct predictions, and that all depends on the data scientist. The role which I am talking about, data scientist is a key player in the company, because based on his decisions, company strategic decisions are taken. So if I predict, suppose my prediction is that my incoming quarter the car sales is going to be double, so what company will do? They will start investing on the production. If my predictions are not right, what will happen? There is a huge loss of money. So all depends on your predictions, how you do it as a data scientist, and based on those predictions, company takes some decisions. Business intelligence is something repeatable, wherein you have the same historical data or maybe additional data, you are using the same algorithms and running it and getting the same results. But data science is reproducible. As soon as the new data is going to become, the algorithm behavior changes. It is going to map a new relationship between the independent and dependent variables. BI tools can be statistical for modeling reports using contained in the repositories, but data science have a lot of tools there in the market today, like R programming, Python programming, Hadoop for scalability, machine learning. So R and Python are the more popular environments these days, but R is something which is less popular as compared to Python, because Python is more scalable in nature. You can do end-to-end programming in Python, but in R you cannot do end-to-end programming. R is a statistical analytical tool. R is a programming language with only statistical analysis. So companies who are using the reports for their internal purposes, they use R. Suppose I am a company, I want to analyze my sales record, I use R programming. But if I am a company who is delivering products to the end users, like a banking domain software or a telecom domain software, then I have to work on Python, because it is capable of working on end-to-end programming. Now today is the era of data science. Now because of the presence of various tools and the frameworks, the challenge no longer exists. So the challenge was what? Challenge was the huge amount of data, challenge was different formats of data, challenge was scalability. All these things have been removed now, because of R programming, because of Hadoop and Spark systems, because of Python, because of cloud environments. We have a terabytes of data storage containers on the cloud. We have scalability problem has been solved, and all these things are done very easily with the help of Python and R, and Hadoop and Spark has an inbuilt Python installed over there. So if you worked on Hadoop, you might have observed that Python is a pre-built programming language over there. All the Unix and Linux system, Python is pre-installed. All the Unix and Linux system like Solaris, HPUX, Ubuntu, everywhere, Python is pre-installed. The role of data scientist is what? Role of data scientist is majorly into analyzing and inciting. You analyze the data, you find the insights into it, prepare the data, that is only 10%, previously it was 65%. Previously, if you talk about 10 years back, people were spending huge amount of time on analyzing, on cleansing the data, or data preparation. Now it has been reduced to 10%. Decision making comes out to be 25%, modeling and iteration 20%, strategizing and analyzing the finding the insights. So you can see data scientist is doing a lot of things in terms of analyzing the data as well as making some decisions. And 25% is a good amount of time he is spending on decision making for future predictions. Now if you talk about the job trends, 2013 McKinsey report predicted that by 2018 there would be a shortage of 190,000 data scientists in the United States only. So this is almost true. You can see the trend of data science, or the demand of data science, is very huge today, and the professionals who are not capable of working on data science is very, very less. Like who are capable are very less. Now you can see cloud computing demand is there. Python demand is 0.79. Hadoop demand is 0.24. So maximum demand is of Python in today's world, which is who are capable of doing data science. Not only Python, but you should be capable of doing data science projects in the company. This is a Google trend. You can see it has been rising since 2016. So what are the roadmaps to become a data scientist? So if you are aspiring to become a data scientist, you should be good in these six fields. First is statistics and probability. Obviously, a person who is not a graduate from stats, he will not be able to understand stats properly. But stats and probability is something which you can learn from time. There are a lot of books in the market. I'll be telling you the name of one good book of stats, that is SK Kapoor and VK Kapoor and SC Gupta. So I'll just write it down the name of the same. VK Kapoor and SC Gupta. Fundamental of Statistics. The book name is Fundamental. And it's a Sultan Chand and Publications. So you'll get this book on the soft copy as well. It's a downloadable book on the internet. If you just try to find the Sultan Chand and Sons publication, S.K. Kapoor and V.K. Kapoor and C. Gupta book, free PDF or free ebook, you'll get it easily. So this book is a really good book in terms of learning statistics as the fundamentals. So this is a pre-requirement. You need to learn stats and probability theory. Then second is you'll have to learn any programming language, maybe R or maybe Python. Then you have to learn data mining, how to get the data from the external sources, maybe some repositories like Oracle or Sybase or MongoDB. Then you have to learn machine learning. Machine learning is all about predictive analysis. Once you read the data, once you explore it, once you cleanse it, once you store it in database, once you get the data, now the next step is predictive analysis. You're going to predict the future. Then big data and Hadoop technologies you have to learn, maybe Spark or maybe Hadoop. And then you have to learn data visualization. So data visualization is something which is at the final state when you are creating a report, but obviously it's a part of Python programming as well as machine learning. So data visualization automatically comes to you when you do all these five steps. Now, what are the responsibilities of data scientists? If you see the job portals and you see the comments over there, they should be good in statistical tools, maybe SAS, maybe SPSS or R. Hands-on experience in statistical tools for decision making, segmentation, logistic and multiple regressions. All these algorithms are there in machine learning in Python. So if you learn machine learning with Python, you will learn all these algorithms quite extensively. So if you see the course from Magna website, you will see these algorithms already placed over there in the course agenda. So let me show you the website. So this is the website. If you just go to this website and see, so in the meantime I'll also open it. It is not showing. Ashwa, can you please ping me the website? mics.magna.in. Oh, I have not put www, that's the reason. What is saying privacy error? Just a moment. Okay, what we'll do is, by the end of the session, Ashwara is going to show you some problem in my machine maybe. So we are going to show you like, that's a website. So I'm going to show you in the last. So all these algorithms, like if you see here, k-means clustering, decision tree, random forest, naive-based classifier, so all these algorithms are the part of the agenda. So when you're going to enroll for the course, you're going to read or you're going to learn from the experienced instructor all these topics, and these are quite frequently used in the company. So there are three types of machine learning algorithms: supervised, unsupervised, and reinforcement learning algorithms. So supervised learning algorithms are those where we know the data completely. When we know the independent variables and dependent variables completely, it's known as supervised learning. Unsupervised learning is where we do not know the data completely and we do not know the column headings. For example, if I give you 10 numbers and ask you to cluster it in two different clusters, what you'll do? You will take a prime and non-prime, you will take a even or odd, you will take divisible by 5, non-divisible by 5, so you will cluster it in different manner. But k-means algorithm is one which is going to cluster the data in two different clusters and everyone is going to get the same answer. So there are decision trees, random forest, naive-based classifier, so all these algorithms are quite frequently used in predictive analysis. So if you see the responsibilities from the different companies, identify problems and also provide solutions with significant impact on business, create logics and algorithms, make business action plans, doing cost-benefit analysis, implementing data-driven solutions, manage the requirements and quality of the project and product. So all these companies who are working in the port of, in the portfolio of data science, so 99% companies are working on data science. Even a sales company, why sales company need data science? To predict the future about the sales. Market basket analysis is done by Amazon and Flipkart, right? So all these companies who are working in different domains, they are working for data science in different areas, right? Sapient is looking for a person who is capable of representing the organization in customer-facing communication, helps effort estimation, lead proof of concept to demonstrate feasibility, approach of execution and delivery, internal external facing through leadership in data science, represent Sapient in relevant industry conferences to build mindshare, and mentor junior data scientists. So you can see the world-renowned companies are looking for people in data science. So when to start, the question comes, when you are going to start off all this? The answer is, today road is empty and there is no hurdle in it. So why I'm saying this? Because in today's world, very less people in India, primarily, India is a growing market. So believe me, like my whole year calendar is blocked in trainings of data science with Python only. Reason being, every company is moving towards it. A lot of companies are giving their trainings, a lot of organizations are giving their trainings, Magna is also giving a training for data science, just because the road is empty today. Demand is high, supply is less, and we can say road is empty, and if you catch hold of this opportunity as soon as possible, you'll be leaders in the coming time. You'll be leading a team where the junior data scientist is going to work under you. Now, if you talk about the course has been divided into different areas. It is introduction to data science, statistical inference, data extraction, wrangling and exploration, introduction to machine learning, classification techniques, supervised, unsupervised, reinforcement learning, text mining, time series analysis, and deep learning. So this is a very good course which has covered almost every topic what you can think of from the data science perspective. It has got time series analysis as well. It has got text mining, deep learning, every topic, whatever you can think of from machine learning perspective and data science, it's there. So who can learn data science? The question comes, am I the right person who is looking for a data science career? So the answer is here. So if you are working in a data analytics field, if you're already working in data analytics field, or if you're working on business intelligence and visualization tools like Power BI, like Tableau, like data warehousing tools, like SAS, Omniscio, Hyperion S-Base, Informatica, it is must for you, because obviously these things are going to be obsolete in the market. So SAS is almost like completely gone from the market, because SAS desktop license was 7 lakh rupees 10 years back. And companies were spending billions of dollars just to acquire the software. Now they have got a free option, Python and R. So obviously these tools are going to be away from the market. So if you are already working on these tools and working on data analytics, it is must for you. You cannot skip it. So BI analytics are just the initial steps. The stairs lead to data science. Till now you find the answers to the questions and help the organization in decision making. You solve the what aspect of the problem. You need to step up and start finding the right question for your organization, which will uncover hidden patterns and unknown correlations. You need to add new skills to synthesize or old skills. So till now, whatever you are doing in data analytics, you are just working on historical data to find what is the insight into it. Now you need to tell the future of it, and that can be done only through machine learning or data science. So if you are working on databases, like Oracle, MySQL, MongoDB, Sybase, of course it is required to work on data science. Now it's time to find and extend your boundaries from data storage to data processing. You can get an idea about dealing with complete data lifecycle. You can explore scientific methods, processes, algorithms, and systems to extract knowledge and insights from various forms, both structured and unstructured. So if you're working on databases, traditionally what you are doing, you are just fetching the data, for modifying it, filtering it, storing it back, using as a repository. There is no intelligent system which is going to give you the automatic answers. You might have observed the chatbots. Like if you book a ticket from GoIBibo, you might have seen the chatbot is there. From various banks, chatbot is there. No human intervention is there. You just type account balance, it gives you the account balance. You just say flight details, it will give you the flight details. Cancel the flight, update the flight, select the seat. Everything has been automated these days. And how it is possible? Through data science only. That is NLTK, natural language processing. If you are a software developer, then of course it is required for you. Since you already know programming, Python will be pretty easy for you to learn. You also have a good database knowledge, therefore you can become a data scientist. Won't be a tough task. You have to learn stats. So that's a new thing that you have to learn. Obviously, a person from the background of BTech or MCA, he would not be having a stats background. But it's not very difficult. You can buy a book, you can read it on your own. It's pretty easy to understand. The data lifecycle and certain algorithms you have to work with. So it's not necessary that you have to read the whole book. You have to just read selectively algorithms like linear regression, like logistic regression, like naive-based classifier, and it will be good for you. Even a fresher from BTech, MCA, MTech can join. As a fresher, you need to first start with data analytics, which will give you an idea about processing, of inspecting, cleansing, transforming, and modeling of data. After that, you can learn machine learning. So obviously, for the fresher, the roads will not be very smooth because most of the freshers are looking for a job, let it be testing or let it be development or let it be automation. They just quickly want to grab the job. So my recommendation is don't just look for grabbing a job if you are a fresher. My recommendation is first become expert in Python and machine learning with data science and then look for a job. You'll get a better job. You'll get a better perspective for a long-term career. So if we talk about career transition, path for data science, so first of all, you have to be very good in fundamentals of computers. Then the next step is you have to learn statistics. Then comes programming language, maybe R or Python. Then obviously machine learning for predictive analysis. Then data visualization, whatever the results you get from machine learning, you have to show it in a form of a template. Then obviously you scale this whole algorithm or the model to a bigger level. So maybe today you are running for 10,000 records, tomorrow you want to run to 10 million records. So you scale it, and scaling can be done only through big data or Hadoop environment. So once scaling is done and a project is up and running on the Hadoop and Spark environment, then you go for a data injection. Data injection means you import more data into it and see whether the software or the code or the project that you have made is working fine or not. If it is breaking, you need to redefine it, you need to debug it, and then finally you munge it. Data munging means joining with the other results, getting more insights into it. And once you do this, you are there for toolbox. You create a tool which is helpful for business intelligence. By then, you will develop a tool which is helpful for business intelligence. And finally, you are solving a bigger problems quite easily. So this is a complete roadmap for data science. And step by step, and all these steps are covered in the training of Magna Infotech, the topics which I shared with you. Obviously, big data will not be there. It's a different training altogether. Big data and Spark trainings are different. But you will get an idea about it, how to work on big data and Spark over there. Now, what are the different benefits of enrolling? So, Magna Infotech, one is class recording. So, even if you miss any of the classes because of urgency, you will get a class recording. So, you will get a lifetime access to the portal, LMS portal, wherein you can watch these presentations at any point of time. Obviously, you cannot download it. If you have a login credentials, you can go there and watch it. There's a placement assistance. So once you are completing the course with a good gradings, definitely the placement assistance will be given to you. Instructor-led live sessions will be there. So like me, somebody is speaking in front of you, and you can ask live questions. You can take live suggestions. It's a completely live session. And multiple projects will be given to you time to time. After completion of every module, you will be given some assignments to cover and you will be given some project to work on. And most importantly, there's 24/7 support. You can call at any point of time to Magna Infotech, and there's somebody who's going to give you a ticket number for assistance and will be taking some 24 hours of time to resolve your query and get back to you. So it's a complete end-to-end development cycle, which makes sure that you learn as per your expectations. So projects are given to you by the end of the session. So this is one of the sample projects which you can think of using our PPR forecast model to predict which employee could be leaving a company, as well as to answer why the company's most experienced employees are leaving prematurely. So every company is looking for employees who want to stay for a long period of time. But if the company faces a lot of attrition, obviously the HR manager would be worried why people are leaving the company. And because of the ratings given by the different areas, like what is the quality of food, whether the cab is given or not, how many working hours are there, whether work accidents are there or not, what is the experience of your senior over there, in which project you are working. So a lot of factors are there because of which people leave the company. And we cannot say this is only one reason because of which people are leaving the company. So in this problem statement, we have a data set which is having all the fields like ratings given by the employee for the different areas. And based on that, you have to find out the right algorithm to figure it out why the people are leaving the company. So generally, in this case, we use logistic regression because leaving is 1 and not leaving is 0. So whenever the dependent variable is categorical in nature, we use logistic regression. So company wants to find out the reason why people are leaving the company, and they want to visualize the distribution of all the employees' relative fields, forecast who are going to leave it. So this is an important factor. HR manager wants to find out who may leave the company in the near future. Comparison among different machine learning models and cross-validating them, finding out why the best and the most experienced employees are leaving prematurely, and giving the final prediction model to the forecast. So this is one of the good projects, a real-time project. Similarly, we have many projects for cancer patient treatment data set, from the telecom domain, from the healthcare domain. So different domains, different projects are there from time to time in the whole course, which will give you a better insight what companies are doing. Now, question and answers from your side. I'll be unmuting you. If you just reply me on the chat window, whatever the questions you are having, or you want to talk to me one-on-one, we can do that as well. Any questions from anyone? Job opportunities of freshers are ample. If you see freshers job, most of the companies, even they are looking for a testers. In the testing field, they are looking for expert in Python or R, because Python has got an inbuilt library for testing called unit test. Similarly, if you are looking for a programming perspective, Python is more popular as compared to Java or C++. So job opportunities, you cannot become a data scientist being a fresher, because data scientist requires good experience, maybe 5+ years of experience in the industry. But as a fresher, you can get a break in your any of the organization if you know good Python with data science. So Akhila has asked, how many hours do we need to spend every day? So all depends on your previous experience, Akhila. If you're from the programming background, you will learn Python pretty fast. If you're not, it will take more time. But on an average, if I talk about people with an average understanding and average knowledge of any programming language, you can become expert in Python in 1 month and expert in machine learning and artificial intelligence in another 3 months. So I can say maximum 4 months are required with a complete dedication wherein you can become a data scientist. Okay, you are from the electrical graduation background. So Python is more beneficial. I would say learn Python rather than R, because scope of Python is more. Yeah, Abhishek, the scope of Python is more. Ashwarya, if you want to take over, you can take over. So all these questions related to price of the course or pertaining to timings, pertaining to batches, everything is going to be answered by Ashwarya. So from Magna, Ashwarya is there.
Hello.
Yeah, sure. We can hear you.
Yes. So can I? Hello, everyone. So actually, there are two types of batches we have: weekend batches as well as the weekday batches. Okay. Suppose if it is weekends, so it will be hardly 20 to 25 days. It takes time. Okay, and you have to spend almost 2 hours every day. Suppose if it is weekends, you have 5 weekends, Saturday, Sunday, there is a different timing based upon your flexibility. So 8:30 p.m. to 11:30 p.m. as usual, you have morning at 7 to 10. So once you complete the course from us, we'll help you with the job assistance also. So max 3 companies we are providing with you. So you have to submit one real-time project to us. Totally 5 projects will be assigned to you. So out of the 5, you have to choose 2. Out of the 2, you have to 1 submit to unlock your certificate. So based upon your certification, so you have to update your resume and share us. We'll upload your resume in our portal. So within the 3 months deadline, we'll give you max 3 companies. So for 3 companies, you can go for the interview. So based upon your priorities, you can decide where you prefer to join. So this is a process. So free or actually, I'll help you with the fee structure. So right now we are providing some offers. Okay. So totally it was 29,000. Yeah.
Yeah, just to answer Abhishek query. See, Abhishek, there are two types of batches. One is a weekend batch, which is morning 7 to 10. Another is a weekend batch evening, that is 8:30 to 11:30 p.m. So you can join any of them, morning or evening. Or you can join weekday batches, that is 8 to 10 p.m. or 8:30 to 10:30 p.m. So there are 3 batches at different times. As per your likings, as per your bandwidth, you can join any of the batch. And duration is weekend is 3 hours, morning and evening 3 hours, either of them, or weekdays 2 hours.
So now I'll help you with the fee structure. So it overall cost you 29,380 rupees, but right now we are providing 20% off. So it comes 23,504. This you can pay through EMI option also available with us. So along with this, we are providing one comp list. We'll send you that list to your mail. So based upon the list, you can decide which course you want to go further. So still any course, please let us know. We'll help you with the details.
Ashley, if you want, you can become a presenter. I don't know. My system is not opening the website.
So there is no any certification exam, because as if I told before, you have to submit one real-time project. So once you submit that project, then automatically the certification will be unlocked. That's it. So if you want to get certification from data science, first you have to go with the contents. After that, you can enroll that exam in some data science. Because data science is an open source.
My sister, I don't know, some problem is there, it's not opening up. So, actually, if you can become a presenter and show the website, it will be more helpful, I think.
Sorry, Abhaya, I can't do that. Let me call Prashant.
Yeah.
Krishna would be there.
I'm trying through Internet Explorer, guys. Just give me a second. Or the website is already there with you. If you can just go and check it. I don't know, some Internet Explorer is blocking it. I'm not sure the reason behind it. Yeah, now I can open it. So if you see my screen. If you go to the website, you'll see all the courses listed out there. So let me come to this. So it is pinned to you on the chat window. So these are all. So if you go to data science, so these are all courses of Python related. So if you are looking for Python certification or data science, this is one of the best courses to become a data scientist. Then is Python programming certification. This is basic Python, which is not having machine learning concepts. So these are the two Python courses which are there for data science. Then we have a course for R programming as well, data science for R, if you are looking for R programming. So all are equally good. So I would recommend to take any one of these, maybe Python certification for data science or Python programming practice. So if you are fresher, better to take Python programming certification course, because machine learning projects you may not get in real time. But if you are having a 2 plus or 3 plus years of experience, you can go for a data science. That is a better course to go for. Any questions from anyone, guys, which you want me to address? Okay, no questions? Okay, guys, thanks for your time. I wish you very good luck for your career. And you can get in touch with the Magna Infotech team offline to get more insights about it. Thanks for your time. Have a great day. Bye-bye and take care.
Thank you, Abhiya, and all our participants. You will receive a survey asking for feedback for this event. Your insights will help shape future events such as this. We will send you a link to the recording of this event so that you can share it within your social networks. On behalf of Magna Infotech Air Services, thank you for joining us today. We hope you find this information and dialogue valuable in enhancing your understanding on data science. If you are interested to know more about on this topic, please do check out our courses on Magna Infotech Air Services portal. So we're signing off and wishing you all a wonderful day ahead. Thank you so much.